On the pretty much coldest day of the year in New York City, we are at PS 33 doing a very special Reading Opens the World event, which is one that's geared to helping migrant children and families that have made their way to New York, you know, after facing really dangerous and terrible conditions.
They're new New Yorkers, so we're embracing them. We're making sure that they have books, and the books are in their native language, so they see themselves in stories, and that's one way to also represent who they are and not forget where they're from as well.
I was there right now.
I just have to say thank you, AFT. Reading literally opens the world, and you're doing that. You're making it real by giving books to the community, and this literature has all kinds of diversity. The beauty of our country, the beauty of the world through multiple languages and cultures. The world is connected through story.
Good job.
I just wanted to come get books because I love books so much. They're like, I just love them because whenever I read a book, I just feel like I'm inside the book. Like whenever I read it, I never put the book down.
He doesn't, yep.
I never do.
You want me to hold it for you?
We know that statistically a lot of students don't have books in their homes. They may have books in schools, they may have books in their classroom libraries, but the reality is that if we limit literacy to the classroom during the day and students aren't able to read at home, then they are going to be behind.
We're teachers, we're educators, we're caregivers. These are children. These children are now going to live here. It's very important for us. You can look at it as, yes, it's good to make good citizens, society, and all the rest of that. But there's a basic humanity. These are children, and that's what we do.
What we're doing today is really trying to create a sense that you are welcome here and helping to create joyful and confident readers. This is what America should be.